what they bring to the table here into the pistol round as we get started.
So the guys from Enemy are actually going to go for a pretty split-up approach initially here. A 3-2 split. Two getting ready to maybe make a play towards the A-bomb site, but then you're still keeping three in the back alleys with the bomb itself, I should mention, too. Potentially getting ready to go for a push in B, but they'll hold back, but it's pretty preserved for now, and they are starting to move the guys off of the A-ramp, so it's probably going to be a pretty solid push. However, Ruru going to drive a wedge in between himself and the rest of the team, but it's not going to be a very solid one, as Nifty takes him down with a nice shot to the dome. And now they have a way opened up to get onto this B bomb site. And one of the players from HG has gone down. And also, we can see here too, Twist is going to get pressured a little bit, but he holds his own and is able to take down mainline.
Yeah, so the trade's coming out favoring the terrorist side right now, but it's going to be Ocean over here by Catwalk to try to hold this one down. Uber does manage to find his way to the end of the B halls, but the bomb is rotating back around through underpass, and actually Ocean's going to hear this, so he revamps his strategy and comes over here towards Cat, but Lucky just denies that play at all from happening, and that's going to be a nice headshot. Relic's pushing around here towards jungle side. Nifty's going to get a second on the round, and it's all down to Twist, who's picked up two kills, looking for some more, but it's going to be Relic's to shut that down, and Selfless going to walk away with the pistol round 1-0 here on the T side.
All right, Nifty, not too bad. He's off to a good start, actually, there. Those two kills are actually pretty quick ones, and he managed to get both of them are headshots, too. So some good accuracy from him. We're starting to see him pick up some shots, but that was just the pistol round. Now we're going to go through the anti-ecos here. And a pretty usual investment with the three rifles and two SMGs, Relics and Uber picking those up. Whereas Ag is going to go for the forced investment here. Three CZs and two 5.7s, all with full armor sitting behind it.
And that's one of the big things. Now they're going to get aggressive here on the A ramp. And Twist is going to play right up behind this smoke, probably until it fades and then fall off. He's actually got a flash as well to work with. He's the only one that's got any nades to work with into this round. Kind of be interesting to see them pop that flash over the top side of a ramp and go for an aggressive push, but there's really not a lot of Selfless players down there to really contend with that area. It's really going to be on Ocean over here at the B-bomb site to try to make something happen, as it looks like there's three terrorists getting ready to make that push in towards that area, but still very passive, slow setup here from Selfless.
And Invert as well, just trying to investigate, make sure these guys are not pushing out for underpass to try and get quick mid-control. But in a pretty safe position, probably not going to be able to spot anything from there, though, as Enemy, or Selfless as they're now called, continue to take things extremely slow. Like, they are barely moving across this map right now. 50 seconds left on the clock. So this is going to be a single play towards one of these sites, and they're going to have to start it now, but it looks like they're actually going to split themselves up a little bit here. Bomb being retrieved now in the back of the B bomb site, but two are going to start the fake out towards A. Whereas in the meantime, the actual bomb is on its way over towards B. And with Uber picking up one kill on the invert there, it should be a pretty easy execute to finish off.
Yeah, this is just on mainline, taking these guns away in the A-bomb site. They did manage to get one gun down. They actually eliminate mainline as well, so that's going to be a 5-7 that's now got a Galil into this round. So a little bit of economical damage being done. So they take one rifle away, they take one MAC-10 away. But one of the things that I actually want to note on that round was... Selfless moving really, really slowly towards the A bomb site. They actually dropped a Molotov down into Sandwich and flushed Nifty out of that position. And, flushed Twist out of that position. And mainline being there, he cleared out all of Palace Halls. He had full line of sight on that. So as soon as that player peeked out, he was able to get that kill with no trade being made whatsoever. So nice use of the auxiliary grenades on the terrorist side to start off the matchup. So definitely showing that Selfless has got some poise into this one.
But Enemy going to be able to close out this round, and hells, no one's going to be able to challenge him. So they retrieve this gun, they keep it going into the next round, and Ruru as well with a MAC-10. Actually, quite a few big guns are picked up there, and that's a little bit of a boost that Ag will hopefully have heading into the third round now. But for Enemy, reinvestments coming out across the board here. Actually curious to see if they're just going to keep one player on a pistol, which is a pretty common thing we start to see some of these guys do. But nope, everybody, four AKs and just a single MAC-10 this time on the main line. So everybody's going to go for the full rebuy here. No risk being taken, especially now with that Galil and MAC-10 in the mix.
Yeah, so now it just is a matter of time to see where they decide to go. Again, because they saved the armor and that SMG, well, not anymore. That SMG is gone. Invert is also gone. Nifty and mainline opening up. And they've already gotten a player into this B bomb site. That's going to be mainline. Now, remember, I don't know if you remember the match that we were casting before. It might not have been you that was casting with me, but it was watching Selfless on Mirage, and it was basically mainline buying a P90 and rushing the B halls every single round.
Lucky, doing some good damage here, managing to pick up the two more kills, and now it's just on Ocean. He tries to sneak his way around through CT, but it's not going to connect. And it picks up that final kill, too. So Enemy start off with a very, very strong lead here. So the guys on AGG, now we see them getting the rifles in their hands. No op investment coming here on this fourth round. Not really able to afford that. As you can see, quite a few of these guys just going to focus on getting the utility investment instead. And it's not really going to leave them with a whole lot in excess, unfortunately, here. So immediately going to be forced out of Eco after this if they're going to drop this first gun around. An enemy on the warpath right off the bat here, going for some mid-control and also pushing themselves into the back of the B site again.
Slow play coming out mid. There's a dink invert. He should be able to know that he dinked that player off of the sound cue off of that one. So getting some early damage out. That's 89 HP. That's just gone off of Uber. But they're pushing very fast off the catwalk. And they're going to spot out Els. They take him down. Nice shot from Lucky. He's going to be able to entry onto this site. He pushes through the smoke. Ocean is behind it. He's going to find one. Finds two. Can't adjust the main line. But it's going to be a two-for-two trade. Coming around here from the kitchen side, it's going to be Invert, who opens up on one, opens up on a second one, and now it's down to mainline. One versus three. What can he possibly do here? He didn't even have time to get the bomb plant.
Agger sitting back, too. They're not even going to pressure him. Nobody pushing out on the site. They knew he's got to be here somewhere with the team. He does have control of the bomb, but he's going to try to sneak his way in here, looking for the first pickup on Invert. No one looking his way, but the spray is very messy. So Invert able to take him down through the corner there, finishing him off. And AGG will be winning the first gun round.
Yeah, and actually, because those last couple of rounds were pretty expensive for the selfless side, they've only got two players that can really fully invest into this round. They might drop an AK over and buy up a Galil or a Tech 9 or two, but this is going to run the well dry for the ex-enemy side. So if they can't get it on the board this round, then they're going to be in a little bit of trouble on their T side to start things off.
Three rounds already on the board, though, through winning the pistol, and when you normally expect somewhere between like 5 and 6 rounds he picked up on this T side, it's not a bad start. Especially if they can bounce things back right here, though. So not really going to be under a whole lot of pressure just as of yet. And if they can keep the economy low, too, just go through the transition round, get yourself onto an eco. And then when you get the guns back up again, you can just immediately stop them from building anything up and force them onto an eco to steal that round right back in your favor. But enemy ready to go for the X2 here on the B-bomb site. Smokes abound, but Ocean picking up a first kill, looking for more, but Nifty finds the trade and takes him down. They're burning on their way in here, so Els will start to pick up some great damage too. He's going to shut down Lucky. They're really, really having a hard time getting themselves outside of the apartments, and they're going to continue to do so as Nifty picks up another kill on towards Els, but he's now the last player alive with 2 HP, and still no progress being made on getting outside of these apps.
And Twist just posted and ready for him, so that's going to break the bank now of the selfless side. They're going to have to go for the eco. And Team Egg getting a couple of rounds strung together now, and just like that, they've forced the save now on the enemy side. So a golden opportunity for them to tie things up, and if they can continue this momentum going on their CT side, it should be relatively good for them moving forward. If they can get, you know, to that 10-round CT side half, that would be great.
But enemy now lining up for a quick push. Switching up the sights now as they're going to work their way towards A, onto their eco round here, and barely anything being brought in. Just some smokes and whatnot to try and confuse the guys from AGG and try to force a plant. But as they rush in there, great pot flash. So Ruru gets so much free damage out. The rest of the team still stuck behind a smoke, actually. So the flash is going to fade away. They're going to try to respond on towards Ruru now, but Twist moving in. He picks up two kills on a Nifty and Uber. And this is just an absolute shutdown. The guys from Selfless get nowhere. And AGG doesn't even lose a single player.
Great use of the grenades right there. That Molotov and smoke combination over by the A ramp just delayed them long enough for them to be able to peek out and find those 1v1 duels, and they end up winning every single one of them. So not a player lost. That's really, really good. You can see the minimal investment. I mean, grand total is somewhere around $3,000, maybe $4,000 invested into this round from Team Ag, combined over 5 players. That's a great investment into a gun round.
So now starting to sneak their way back out. Nifty looking for the shot inside of the window to try and take down Invert. Again, he's been actually pretty good so far with the rifle and trying to pick up some of these kills. But the rest of the team now, still not going to follow suit and trying to take more control of middle. But there we go. There's Nifty finding that kill into Invert. Shuts him down from inside of the window. Lucky watching for a push as there's no one actually in the back of the B site. So they're going to be a little bit vulnerable here. But this is all to try and line up a push to get themselves inside of Connector and eventually out towards the A bomb site too. As the bomb's actually going to start to wrap back around from middle and position itself just outside of the T-steps. Lucky sneaking up, though. He finds another kill, takes down Ruru, and just like that, they found their pass into the A-bomb site.
Yeah, Twist feeling like he has to make a play there, pushes aggressively into Palace, and he pays for it. Relix is going to be able to take him down, and now it's down to Ocean and Els. These are the two B players, so it looks like they're going to opt to go ahead and push into B-halls and hold onto their rifles for this one, as no fatalities on the enemy side to start this round out. Now, not necessarily any kind of exceptional take from the selfless side. It's just that Nifty got a really nice shot through the smoke And then Lucky was able to creep up onto Ruru, who was playing aggressive there in the connector room. So those two kills completely unanswered. Now they're going to go for a little bit of a hunt here. Lucky at least spots out one. The money's not good, so they really shouldn't be chasing here.
Enemy going to start to move into positions at the very least to try and stop them moving anywhere else. As now Nifty watching out to see if they try to retreat towards the B-bomb site, and we'll see in a second if they are actually going to move in and look for these kills, but they'll be mollied out, so no way. Actually, he's going to move in, pushing through the molly now, but 12 HP after he gets outside of it. That's going to be handing over his life on a silver platter, so Ocean finds one more kill before the round ends. Bit of an unfortunate play there from Relics. I think he thought he could have gotten out of the molly a lot quicker.
Yeah, a little bit of a bummer there at the end, but nevertheless, it is going to be another round on the board here for enemy GG, or Selfless as they're now known, but another buyout here, and Invert actually has the AWP now. This is the first time that we've seen the AWP come out in this matchup. It comes 8 rounds in, and look at this mid-presence coming out from Egg. So this is going to be very interesting to see them push on up here, and now Invert's going to get a line of sight onto Underpass, and he's going to capitalize onto Lucky, so nicely done.
Nifty sitting back now. He's been pressured. It's going to be a flash tossed over here, but as Ruru attempts to push, Nifty holds his own, losing about half of his HP. But with Els jumping up there, he's going to get spotted, but thankfully another pop flash is thrown in there, and Els finds a trade to shut down Nifty. Invert with a great shot in the main line as he's dropping down from Tetris, and then follows it up with another one on towards Uber. Just like that, enemy are down for the count, and very quickly are going to tap out there with Twist finding the final kill on the Relics. This game remains very close now at 4-4.
Yeah, it's a close matchup, and there you see the little bit of a change that happened on the Ag side was that AWP coming into play. Now that Invert's got that, he picks up 3 kills in the round that he has it, because now they go for that mid presence. Now they go for that aggression up mid that opens up the underpass peak, and he finds that opening pick. So already, you know, 15 seconds, 20 seconds into the round gives his team an advantage moving forward into this one. So nicely done from him, and then Ag just capitalize on it as the round goes on.
So enemy actually is going to try the same play that we saw last time when they were on an eco here too. Not really like a whole lot that we could really expect from these guys when they take these super light ecos. Some of them don't even buy anything at all when you look at mainline and Nifty. But some are going to approve for some pistols to maybe try and find a couple trades here too. They find Twist back over towards CT, but him and Ruru are going to pick up 2 kills. So far mainline only finding Ruru. But with mainline picking up that gun there, he's also going to be able to take down Twist too. Invert traded that back out by shutting down Lucky. And mainline trying to take some duels with these players over here just outside of jungle. But unfortunately, the real task here is to get the bomb down. So he needs to go back to this. He succeeds in doing so. But now he'll be the last player left alive in a 1v3. And he's stuck in the corner here by Firebox. And what do you know? It's going to be fire that forces him out of it, and Ocean still with plenty of time to defuse the bomb.
That smoke on CT had a huge gap in it, in which Ocean, I believe, came around from CT side and could have easily prevented the bomb plant. Uber basically just suicide ran right in front of Ocean in order to deny him from preventing the plant. So, an interesting little bit of a play there. Granted, they don't win the round, but the main objective was to get the bomb down to put the extra money in the bank so that they can buy up these AKs going into this round, which is exactly what they're going to do, and they've got full arsenal of nades to work with as well. If Uber doesn't make that play and they kill the bomb planter, that round is over, and they don't get that extra 800 bucks. You know, that's a smoke, that's an HE, that's a flash grenade that they might not have going into this round.
So, enemy back to the split play. Taking things a lot slower this time, and obviously from their positioning too, probably going to take some time to investigate over here towards middle. We're trying to throw that fake back towards A. They're just keeping these players now watching for aggression from AGG, and AGG have still kept this mid play too. They're still trying to hold an iron grasp here on the area of middle. Ruru's pushed forward. He's not going to find anything there, but Invert catching Uber picks up the first kill of this game now, and already one of the guys from Selfless going down. Not going to be a good omen because it is going to split the final two here as well. Thankfully, no one's pushed in to try and drive that wedge and actually spot the bomb too, because we've got Nifty defending that. But now the question becomes, all right, we've lost a player. We still are all super split up. So where are we going to try to execute upon, as we've got no ground to work with?
Yeah, and Ocean playing up here in the window. He's actually going to fall back from this position, as there was a flashbang that came over the top of that B hallway. But bomb is slowly rotating back towards the A bomb site. And with Uber down and out, that's one of their very formidable powerhouse entry fraggers, and he's actually having a relatively quiet match. He's 2-6 right now, so he really hasn't made much noise much of a ruckus in this matchup so far, and you can see they're playing very, very passively on this A bomb site. Ruru is actually up on top of Firebox. That's the only spot of aggression that they have on the map right now as far as the CT side is concerned. Twist going to go ahead and drop a Molly over here towards the A ramp. They know that a hit has got to be coming here in a second, and that Molotov is going to burn precious seconds off the clock, and Twist opens up on the main line. So very disconnected from his teammates as that push is very, very slow.
Invert picking up yet another kill for the CTs. Now they're just trying to force the plant, but Twist can't realize there. Relic's taking some time to notice it, but he does spot Ruru inside of Firebox and finds the trade. But 8 seconds left, goes for the fake plant, gets up another kill on the Twist, and now moving back in here, tries to shut out Invert, but Invert gets the point blank shot. He's on point with that op today, and he's going to find another 3-kill round here.
Yeah, he's doing really, really well with the op. That's unfortunate for Twist, though. He probably would have been able to take down the last player, but he gets flashed by his teammate just enough that, I believe that was Relics at the end, was able to find that last kill before he fell down. So, a little bit of a miscue, but that's only one rebuy going into this next round, or pardon me, two rebuys into this round, as Twist and Ruru were the only ones to die in that last gun round. So, nicely managed again from Team Ag. They're going to move on forward into another full arsenal. It's going to be a Tech-9 armor buy from the CT, or from the Terror side of Selfless.
Rover's a mid-control too, but it does end up getting spotted out by Els, so he's going to try to hold this, picks up one kill. Relics finds a headshot though to trade it out, but they do know that the play is on its way, and Invert just drops right down there and finishes off Relics. Now there's no separate angle that this play is going to work its way towards, and Ruru almost finishing off the final players on his own, picks up a 2-for-1, and Invert rolling in there yet again to find the final kill. ADG only going to lose 2 players that time to an enemy trying to rush, and the enemy with no plant won't really have anything to show for that round, but they go right back into another gun round. Interestingly enough, we still do not have an op to be seen yet from Nifty, and he's going to be much slower this time, so he's not even going to be able to afford a rifle. He's only going to have a Deagle.
Yeah, and that's a little bit risky for him, especially since Nifty is leading the charge for him at 8-7 on the scoreboard. He's been doing a tremendous amount of work for him, but this time around, again, it's going to be Invert with the AWP opening things up, and that's already an AK down on Catwalk. Nifty goes down at the top side of mid. Uber does manage to answer back. Lucky coming from underpass, but Invert's going to take the fight and takes him down. So 2 more kills for Invert. Twist onto Relics at the A bomb site, and it's all down to Uber now trying to hightail it out of mid and get himself back around towards B, but Ocean pushes the B halls. He's actually in underpass right now, so Uber could get in towards B and maybe try to get a bomb plant, but Ocean's actually coming back on up. They spot each other, and now the information is relayed. 23 HP left for Uber. Not a lot that he's going to be able to do, and especially if he goes in towards B, because that rotation is already there. Els is there.
He just gave away his position to you by firing, so now everybody can just rotate off the A bomb, so they know for sure he's here. And even Twist is going to move in and box him in, not even give him a chance to fall back and try to rotate towards A. So he's got T-watched. And as Uber tries to crawl his way out of here, he's basically set his own grave up. As soon as he peeks his head out over here towards the site, he's going to have to win a duel or end up going down. And it will be the latter that ends up happening, with L shutting him down. And ADG and Alp to 8 rounds. Enemy, after getting their guns, or after the guys from ADG, I should say, have gotten their guns in their hands, we just haven't seen all that much pressure coming out from enemy. And they seemed a lot more timid now. And as well, the economy management has just been abysmal here. They barely had enough cash to go for full buys in quite a few of these rounds. And even when they had, there's still no op presence being seen as of yet from Nifty. So ADG just shutting things down here so far since the middle portion of this half started.
Yeah, and again, it's going to be another underpass push. I was clearing out information, so Selfless probably getting aggravated from the aggression here from the ag side. Ag. And yeah, so now it's another pistol armor buy from the Selfless squad, and they're opting to go back towards A. They haven't had much luck here. And there's a pop flash in, pushing the smoke is Ruru, and he's going to get taken down. So mainline's now got an M4 to work with, and we saw him do a little bit of damage with this the last time coming into the A-bomb site. But look at the rotation. There's already 3 CTs here.
Molly going to get tossed onto the ground. They're not really going to connect a whole lot of damage. They bring mainline and Uber down a little bit here, but Twist pick up that first kill. They know they're trying to go for a heavy play towards Sandwich, but Ocean spraying him down, picks up 2. Relics and Lucky, and Hell's wrapping back around, stops Uber from retreating away yet again. So AGG with another very clean hold there, an enemy with another force that does not go very well at all. Comes the op from Nifty, and now is the real test here, is how well is this new replacement from Kusta going to be able to do with his primary weapon?
Well, here's the rub with this whole situation, is because they've been going for these force buys, this is the first time that he's had an op all half, and it's 2 rounds from the end of the half. Invert picked up his op at the 8th round, and he's had it ever since then, and now he's 15-4. So you see what the impact of that scope rifle has been, at least for the CT side. So a little bit rough here for the ex-Selfless squad, and he actually doesn't even get a chance to shoot the off because the mid-aggression comes out from Ruru.
Rue going to move in again for a second pickup. Mainline jiggle peeking him a little bit there, but Mainline ends up winning the race, takes him down. It'll be a one-for-one trade to start off this round, but AGG are still keeping their aggressive tendencies here. L's pushing up towards mid. He wants to find that trade to take down Mainline, but as he peeks out, he not only has Mainline to deal with an op, but even if he would have missed his shot, Relix was sitting just behind him up on top of that porch there, so more than likely would have died regardless. And you're really not going to get a whole lot of intel for that kind of play either. I don't believe he would have been there long enough to be able to spot the bomb. So AGG's three remaining players are just going to be split up.
Yeah, this is a golden opportunity for enemy to get to five rounds, or selfless to get to five rounds. But the big part about it is how spread they are. But they're reading the situation right. And Invert actually coming over here towards B. Ocean's over here as well. They hear the op shot get rattled off. And now, oh, look at this. Uber's going to get found out. He gets seen and he gets taken down. So Twist, nice job over there at the A bomb site. 35 seconds. They've got to make a play, and it's going to be to go down through underpass and try to abuse this one player that's playing at the A bomb site. So Twist, he's going to have an opportunity to get underneath the balcony and try to hold this one down as the terrorists come trucking on in. Are they going to clear it out? Relic's coming around the side, doesn't spot it. There's the bomb down, looking for another one. Twist going big this round. That's three kills for him, and now Lucky, he's got it all to do. And Ocean coming around from connector. This should be an easy cleanup, and it is.
Twists with the big plays from him there too. Great hold and great overall, great controlling his presence there on the A-bomb side too. Keeps his position a secret that entire time and just absolutely decimates everyone from enemy. Credit to, or Selfless as they're now called, a little bit of a credit against the guys from Selfless for sort of not checking that sort of stuff with him finding those earlier kills too, but he just shuts it down. The younger talent here from Twist showing off in that round and stopping enemy from winning it there after they had a pretty good start.
Yeah, and again, Uber in mid, gonna find some good damage onto Invert, drops the AWPer down to 44 HP, but not able to execute the kill, and again, with that being an AWP, it's a one-shot killing machine, so even if you've got one HP, you can still make a huge impact into the round. Now, he's gonna have to be careful because Relix has crept his way up here to the end of the apartment hallway, so if he peeks out, he might be able to actually spot Invert as he's not looking in the right direction. Actually, does smoke that off, and they're gonna push on through that smoke, and they catch him out, and that nade's gonna be off the mark. Mainline down to 9 HP, but they've gotten a little bit of A-bomb site control. Actually, pardon me, but they've got all of A-bomb site control. And now it's going to be a matter of these players rotating back in, pushing the Molotov. Lucky gets caught out. He doesn't know where those shots are coming from. Uber's going to go down as well. Very close to going down here in connector, pardon me. It's going to be all down to Daddy O'Dig. What can he do? 1v3.
And Mainline even pulled back there too, as he did not want to go for the peak. But Mainline's presence is actually perfect because he puts himself just on top of the bench and it lines it up to finish off Ocean as he comes out of the corner. So AGG with a dominating first half on CT side will end it 10-5. An enemy here on the CT side have a whole lot of work to do to get back into this game.
Yeah, but five rounds on the T side, still not a terrible half from the Selfless squad. A pistol round victory here is going to put them right back in this one. So we'll see if 10 rounds is going to be enough for Team Ag, or if Selfless can come back into this one. It's all going to start in the pistol round coming up next, guys.
I think, obviously, CT side, like I was talking about before, economy manager for enemy on T side was very, very questionable. Since there was a whole lot of force buys coming out, I think they were just expecting to outfrag AGG in these aim duels here, even with Tech Mines or whatever they would be downgraded to, and that was just not the case. Quite a few of the guys from AGG are actually performing really, really well here, really up to par. L specifically, along with Invert, had quite a few big rounds. Invert was doing some work with the op. Ocean showing up in quite a few of these rounds to finish off situations would might have gotten a bit dodgy, and Twist with that big play, finding the three kills too after there had been 1-2 trade at the beginning. AGG is on point today, and that's not something you normally see for a newer team like this, where every single member is basically having rounds where they're being the star player for the team. So they're looking just overall much stronger right now than enemy. And another player too for enemy that's actually doing really weak right now. I have to check the scoreboard when we go live again, but Uber, for majority of this half, was barely present in terms of his fragging power, where normally he's the player that leads the charge. And considering the fact that they no longer have Kusi, he kind of has to step up to be this big player for these guys. He's just not doing that right now.
Yeah, so again, going into this second half, it's going to be really about the momentum. Is ex-enemy or Selfless going to be able to carry momentum from that last final round that they got into the pistol round, pick that up, and then run with it in the second half? Or is Team Ag going to close things out? Because if they win the pistol round, you could potentially see that 13-5 scoreline, and that's a tremendous hill to climb for Selfless. So it's going to be very, very interesting to see. And here we go, live into this pistol round. So, Blue, why don't you take us away here, brother?
All right, let's get into it, guys. We'll be live on three now. and checking it out just to solidify the point there too. If you open up the scoreboard, Uber is in the bottom of the team right now. It's Mainline leading the charge, and Nifty, the temporary fifth, sitting just behind him at 8 frags. Whereas the rest of the team a little bit close to him though, so it's not like he's leading by a huge margin. Mainly Mainline doing most of the work with these guys right now. But here we go now, starting off the second half. And the investment from AGG going to be pretty usual here for the T side, bringing quite a few flashbangs along with the smoke on Ocean. They're just going directly over towards the B bomb site to try and line up a push.
And they're actually going to boost here into the B bomb site, and they get this boost up in time. That push hasn't come out yet from the T side of Ag, and looks like they're actually. Well, it looked like they were falling off of the B halls, but this time if they do push in, Lucky is actually jump spotting this, so he's going to actually spot one out. Ocean coming out, playing a little bit of a lurk role here, trying to distract over the A bomb safe, but he's going to get one tap by Relics playing on the back firebox. And now it's going to be a push in towards B. Lucky, Mainline, chiming in. Going to be one more here for Lucky as well. Last man standing over here on catwalk, and L's can't get it done. Mainline picks up a second one of the round, and Selfless going to go very clean into this second half.
Yeah, that was an absolute shutdown there. Enemies, or Selfless's players, on point with their pistol fire. So that's two pistols in a row. I believe they won the one in the first half too, but they did the same thing in the last half, and they won the anti-ecos pretty easily. But the big question is going to be, how will they fare once AG gets the big guns into their hands? No plan happening this time, so it's just going to be a light investment. And as well, there's not going to be a whole lot of utility on AGG, so they're going to have to get really, really lucky to actually try and find a plan here, which would enable a third round force buy.
Yeah, you're going to have to get creative, and creative is what they're going to do. They're just going to barrel on out from Palace, and Uber and Relics are just shutting it down. And there you go. Relics, the money-making machine this round. That's $1,800 that he just pocketed on that 3K from the UMP. So well-positioned, well-played, and well-defended from the enemy, and that is going to put 7 rounds now on the board for them.
I don't know if I would call that creative, necessarily, like 5 players rushing out of Palace. That's more of like a Hail Mary than being creative. Which is my thoughts. And this is basically, everybody push out. Let's hope one of us gets at least 2 kills so that we can try to get the plant here and the site's clear enough. And it just didn't work at all. So, AGG. Gonna start to lose their lead a little bit here. Still with a strong solidification on it, at least for this last round here, as AGG once again goes for a pretty hefty save. Mostly just P250s on the board here. And the guys from Selfless just shutting them down. Relics finding 1 kill there. We've also seen Twist go down. And barely any damage under the guys from enemy, but the last moment push now coming in for Mate. They're gonna try to overwhelm Lucky, but he holds on to his own. Ocean though, midair, finds the trade on the Lucky and takes him down, but the Molly getting tossed a little bit to the left. It does force Els out of hiding, and a little bit of damage to Ocean, so Nifty's gonna finish it off with a scout shot. And enemy will close out this round two to put it up to 8-10 before we see the guns getting in either team's hands. Big guns, that is.
Relics has got a lot of money. $10,000. He got 5 UMP kills in 2 rounds. I'd actually kind of like to see him hang on to the UMP for another round just to see if he can rack up a couple more kills with it. And it looks like he might actually do that, which would be really cool to see because that is very strong against armored players. 2 taps to the head. So, interestingly enough, he will stay on the UMP. He's got $10,000. He bought down a little bit. He's at 9,300, but it's against the full buy this time around, but they're playing the money management game. You can see they picked up 2 FAMASs, or at least kept 2 FAMASs out of the last round. And that's going to bode well for them as far as the money is concerned. Nifty bought down. He's going to be on an AWP. And Lucky had to buy down because he died over at the B-bomb site last round. So $1,000 for him and $1,450 for Nifty. But the rest of them are sitting pretty good, pretty healthy with this economy.
So Team AGG going to focus most of their pressure over here towards mid early on in the round. I believe with an eventual goal, they're trying to line themselves up with a push to get over towards Cat Twits. He's going to get himself into this smoke, but Nifty, in the meantime, was allowed a shot onto Inverts. They shut him down. He is smoked out the wazoo now, though, so he cannot stick here. He's going to have to wrap around, but Twist, he's going to lock onto the headshot there and takes Nifty down. He missed the shot onto him from inside of Connector, so they find that trade, even it back down to a 4v4. And now that they have a bit of an advantage here they can work with, they are going to try to push this towards the B-bomb site. Enemy or Selfless is going to have to read this pretty quickly, and I believe they are, as they're already starting to shift the majority of their players closer to B to start to cover that more.
Yeah, you can see Relics actually coming on through the window room, and he's actually going to have an AWP. He's going to get there just in the nick of time, catches the backside of Ruru. The mollies go out, and it's a trade of kills. 2 of them get burned alive. It's going to be Mainline and then Els to follow up. Now it's going to be Relics with this AWP. He's going to find the first one, Ocean with the AWP. Not really known for his AWPing skills, but we'll see if he can lay it down in a 3v1 because he's only got 25 seconds, and he's not even going to get that far. Lucky blindsides him, takes him down, and another round for Selfless. They're now within one.
And we'll keep the investments going pretty strong here too. AGG, Now the question is, okay, can we go all in and force again? And yep, that's exactly quick answer to that question. As we see four AKs coming right back onto the board. Invert is going to be the odd man out with a scout. And also a much, much less stock of utility coming in for most of AG's members this time around. Just a smoke and a couple flashbangs, if even that, for most of these guys. So a very quick setup and a very quick push onto the A-bomb site will be the go-to strat for this team.
And that's going to be really what it is. They've picked up all of these smokes, so they've at least got that behind them as far as the utility is concerned. But a scout on invert, that's going to be so tough for them to work with as far as going into this A bomb site. He's going to have to try to work a pick quickly up into the A halls here, but he can't really even go through. Ruru and Els are going to lead the charge on out into A, and now we're going to have a bit of a brawl over here as there are four CTs to try to defend this. And you've got one in the back of the site trying to get up on top, and invert, there it is. He's making the scout work, trying to go for the jump scout as well. Not going to be able to connect onto Uber. Uber trying to fend off these players here from back ticket booth, and he is going to be able to find one in Ruru.
Lucky flashing back in. They managed to completely blind L, so they take him down. But also another team flash, I think, is tossed in, so it's going to hold them back for a couple extra seconds. But they're making some good progress in the retake. Unfortunately, Ocean, on point with his aim, shuts down mainline. Nifty moving back in, takes out Ocean, but Twisted found another kill too. Nifty with the spot, though, takes down Twist from behind Firebox, and he knows Invert is sitting in the corner. Huge play from Nifty, and he just finishes off three players back-to-back-to-back, shutting it down. And of course, the defuse is going to be no problem with plenty of time left on that clock.
Really nicely done from him. They managed to save the AWP as well, so that's going to get tossed back over to him. Tied up 10-10, full AK buy on the board now. They did go for a force up in the last round, but they're in the money bonus now, so they're going to be able to buy up here. They've got a decent amount of utility behind this as well, so see if they opt to go for another fast A hit, but the bomb is actually working its way around towards the top side of mid. This time around, the CTs of Selfless not actually putting that op into window room, so... Where is Nifty going to be playing? He is actually over at A this time. No, pardon me, he's at the back of B. So they're switching up the positions, trying to stay mobile, but this time would have been a great round to have him up in mid.
They want to put him in the pressure spots, though. This is a good chance to test him, too, and this is perfect because it's been red. This is good calls coming out now from the leadership on the side of Selfless. Nifty's going to have to spot this. I think Nifty's gotten a little bit too aggressive, though. Here's the problem. Is that if AG have good pressure, utility trying to cover this rush, then Nifty might just get overwhelmed. However, Invert overpeaks, so he spots it, and now he's going to have time to smoke it off and start to fall back a little bit. Got to call in for some help here. Lucky falling back from middle, but there's smokes rolling in through arches, so he can't see anything. He's going to have to pop flash his way back in here pretty quickly. Nifty's managed to escape, though. He's on the back site now. Ruin shuts down mainline, but Lucky responds, takes down Ocean. Twist picking up that trade kill to eliminate Lucky. Goes down to a 3v3, then spotted Nifty. Twist going to move in, takes down a flash relics, finishes off Nifty as he saw that rifle around the corner just moments before, but now it's going to be all done to Uber, but Uber taking his jolly old time rotating in from that A bomb site, going all the way around to Cat. So Team AGG is going to have plenty of time to get to their post plan positions.
It's going to be all right because they just now realize that he's coming from Cat side. Twist, though, is going to be able to take him down. That's a big 4K for Twist on the round. The young gun, the new acquisition for Team AGG, is going to be able to find that. Now I believe we might actually have a pause coming out from the Selfless side. Maybe just talk about what they need to do, because they were running rounds together, and then this B bomb site just gets taken relatively easily from Team AGG.
Like we were saying before, I think they had the good read on Nifty trying to hold the pressure from B, but the problem was there is that I don't really think Lucky ended up in a good position to try and assist the team. I believe that was Lucky that was sitting on Cat, because he had to fall back, but he didn't really fully recommit himself to the B bomb site. And there was a really great smoke setup that came in from AG, so they were able to smoke him off completely. He had to pop flash his way back in, and it just created this really awkward encounter initially that Nifty wasn't really able to utilize all that well after picking up his first frag. And this combined, too, with the pretty quick pickups that we saw Relics, or not Relics, apologies, I think it was Invert. We saw Invert finding there, pushing back in, and picking up two more kills onto the site itself. It's enemy being basically outclassed there on the B-bomb site. So again, good play from AGG. Just enemy misappropriating their players just a little bit there.
Yeah, so I expect to see Nifty going back towards window room this round, maybe even playing ticket booth in the A-bomb site, and then putting two dedicated rifles over at the B-bomb site. Him being able to pick up that opening pick and no trade coming out, just because he was able to get so aggressive in halls and get that forward position, he was able to bail out through the window. He actually even had time to drop a smoke in halls and go for a re-peek up by Van before dropping a Molotov out. So that was interesting. Pardon me, interesting in its own right, but this time around he's going to be in window room, and they do go for the two dedicated rifles over at the B-bomb site, so this is the right call from Selfless.
And AGG back to taking it slow for this round, of course, but Uber Maybe looking to get a bit aggressive too. The smoke is set up for the CTs inside of the T ramp, but there's not really anything for him to see through. So after it fades away, he's gonna be falling back and will hold the safe position underneath the platform, waiting for any inevitable push to come towards the site. His assistance will be in the form of relics. However, enemy or selfless have now put quite a few of their players closer towards the B bomb site after what ended up occurring in the last round, and they're gonna want to keep them there. But there is a possible fake brewing depending on how AGG want to position their players, and they too, I think, are still trying to make a decision as to where they're going to take this. But they're starting to move out of the back of the B site and the tunnels over there, so this may end up being an A hit after all, depending what the next few seconds hold here for the movement on AGG.
Did Invert just shoot at his teammate?
I was not paying attention to him.
I thought I might have just seen him try to hit a flick on his teammate. He might have shot L's down to 64 with that AWP. I'm not sure when that damage actually came out, but that may or may not have been what it looked like to me. But nevertheless, who knows? A lot of smoke's going in towards A. If Nifty doesn't bite on this, he's going to have himself a field day at B. They're going to walk right into this. Oh, no, he turned the timing every friggin' time, but he does end up sticking around. He finds the first one, looking for Ruru as well. Goes for the repeat, but Ruru is going to capitalize. The bomb is very split up, and look at this fast flank from Lucky.
Uber's moving in so quick, too, to try to get himself in market, but he hears Twists. So they know that that player's moved out towards mid and is probably going to move in to assist his teammate somewhere over towards catwalk. Lucky moving in towards the site now. He hasn't actually spotted Ruru. He's now going to move himself out of position, but just as we were talking about that, the guys from Enemy find them both and shut them out with the snap of a finger. So Enemy will close out this round. They'll retie the matchup at 11 rounds for both teams. And of course, now for AGG, I believe this is going to reset their economy once again, and in fact it is. But still might be enough money for a Tech 9 force if they want to try to do that.
I was actually watching the playback on the stream right there, and it was actually Invert shot L's with the AWP. He flicked on him. I was barely paying attention at the time, and I saw him for some reason pull the bolt back on the AWP, and I was wondering what the hell he was shooting at because he had a teammate in Palace, a teammate at A ramp, and a teammate coming from T-spawn to mid, and he ended up shooting him to 64. So a little up tap there, no big deal, but that's going to be that round. And look, Relic's back onto the UMP. He's going to go for some money farming, but he's got to be careful because it is a Tech 9 armor buy.
But for AGG, going back to the basics in terms of what they're going to do strategically here, it's just an all-out push to the 8 bottom side, all 5 pushing it at once. The blind spray through the smoke at Palace, too. Their teammate doesn't actually want to push out to Palace just yet, as they haven't cleared it. So Relic's going crazy with the UMP. He takes down Invert and Ocean, so it's just down a Twist and Ruru now. And Ruru is at 15 HP as well. These guys really can't do anything. They've got good smoke coverage, so they may try to move in and get the bomb onto the floor. But Twist, he's looking for kills, and he's going to find his own death in the process, running into Lucky around the corner. Lucky shuts him down. Now Ruru trying to pull up the impossible with a minute left on the clock. He's going to back up a little bit there, but a nice headshot on a Nifty dispatches of him. Pop flash rolls over. That should pull Lucky back over towards the steps. Mainline still hugging that left side of jungle. If both these guys peeked at once, they would have been able to take him down. Now he's going to fake the plant. Just trying to confirm that there's nobody over by CT. However, that gives away his position, and they just molly him out.
Yeah, it would have been nice to see him try to stick the plant there, get the extra 800. Of course, he has no way of knowing that. Uber immediately onto the P90. He knows that it was a Tech 9 armor buy. He knows that they're not going to have any money because they didn't get the plant in the last round. So he's going to go for the nerd mower here and try to lay it down into this round. So enemy GG, or ex-enemy, new selfless, actually taking their first lead in this matchup since pistol round of the first half. So that's huge.
Now it's all about keeping it, though, as we've seen them been battling this battle for quite some time, but already Relic's, as you were mentioning before, they already knew this was an eco round, so Relic just gets super aggressive, pushes, finds Twist, and the team is completely unaware of the fact that he had gotten this aggressive, so they're going to combo this into a second kill, too. L's moved to the top mid to find a trait. That's a long-range duel versus a rifle when you have no armor, and at most a P250, so another kill will be scored for Relic's for free. With virtually zero damage, and in fact, yeah, exactly zero damage going on to the guys from Enemy so far. Another Nate connects on the Ocean, he's down at 78. Relic's peaks mid again and finds another kill, takes down Ruru. So this is the buffet for Relic. Not mainline, he wants some of it. He's gonna pop flash his way out to the apartments there and takes down the final two.
Yeah, it was a beautiful pop flash, caught him completely off. Takes him down, and now a two-round lead for Selfless, moving forward into the 10th round of the second half. They're going to have plenty of money to work with. Mainline, I believe, actually getting the P90 from Uber, maybe? Yeah, so Mainline's going to have a P90 this time around. We've seen him do some work with this in the past. He's He's actually up there with the rest of his team. It's Uber that's lagging behind right now at 9 and 12. He does have 4 assists, but Relic's leading the charge at 21, 17 for Lucky, 16 for Nifty, and 18 for Mainline. So each player contributing in their own right, with the exception of Uber, who's a little bit behind the rest of them.
Bag back to kicking it up here now. As Lucky gets aggressive, he pushes down. There's a great pop fly. Moves in. Invert's dead. Ocean's dead. And they get control of the bomb. And this was perfectly timed for enemy too, because they were about to push in from underpass. So they're going to get two more kills potentially. Ruru strikes back a little bit. He's able to take down Relics, but he can't continue to force his way out there because enemy's just waiting for him around the corner. If he goes out towards that, he's going to be a dead man. So now Els and Ruru have to try and find some way to recover to this. Thankfully, there's not a whole lot of pressure on the bomb, so Els can recover this, but they're still working a 2v4 with zero map control, and Ruru is stuck in a very hard position now to hold.
Yeah, and the big thing is if Nifty actually rotated around a connector to watch that, but he actually hightails it through Murder Hole and works his way back towards the A bomb site, so they're going to stack up 2 and 2. They've actually given up connector control, but Uber is up in the Palace Halls. Oh, and Nifty actually peeking a little bit late. He doesn't realize that Ruru has made it into jungle. So from this position, he might be able to find some extra damage. Maybe onto this player over here in CT. It's Lucky, and Lucky is going to be ready for it. Takes him down. That's a triple on the round for him. L's coming from connector side. At least takes the AWP out of the hands of Nifty.
Now L's 20 seconds left on the clock. He's going to have to try to work something here, but he's been surrounded. Mainline peeking in through connector. Uber getting into a battle with him too, and Uber, he did fully commit himself up to the top of the steps. He is going to be able to close things out there. So 14 to 11. Enemy have mounted their lead up and are continuing to move forward with it here as well. And for AGG, there's just not enough money left. If they want to force it here to try and prevent enemy from getting up to the 15th round, they're going to do it. And it looks like that is what the plan is going to be. A bit of a last minute one too, with this buy happening with just about 3 seconds left on the clock before the round starts. So I'm not imagining anything super advanced or super planned from AGG, which does not give me good hopes, because most of these forces have just not gone that well before this as well, as we take a look at the history in this half.
Yeah, one of the big things, they didn't salvage the AWP into this round, so Nifty had to buy down. He's at 100 HP, but look at this stack that they have in mid. Lucky watching from connector, gets the headshot onto Ruru. Now if they go for that mid presence, they've got the head stack here in middle, and that's Uber up on top. The smoke comes out, but look at how fast he can get up on Cap behind this. He's going to be able to spray down 1 to 32 HP. Mainline is going to be there. Uber's going to be able to check in with another one, and Lucky is there for the cleanup. This round is over.
L's holding out for now. Picks up a kill into Uber and retrieves the bomb, but it's basically the same situations that we've had in plenty of these rounds before, where enemy just decimates AGG early on in the gun round, or the gunfight, I should say. And then it's brought down to just one player to try and clutch out an impossible task. So he'll be running away. Looks like he's going to try to push his way over towards the B bomb site. 50 seconds left on the clock. There's basically zero hope of him being able to save this gun. If this had happened much, much later on in the half, okay, maybe he could go hide in a corner and try to keep this gun for the next round, since they're not really going to have anything, but this is not the case. He has to attempt, try to get the bomb down to give his team a little bit of extra cash, but as he pushes in, Relics is waiting for him. Els with a good spot, actually. He does see him boosted up on top of there, but now his teammates have been alerted, so as he pushes back in, Relics just going to win the duel anyway. So there you have it, 15 to 11, and AGG are just going to force up with pistols here, and what's going to be the final round? Actually, they can probably afford a couple rifles, too, now that I'm looking at the money they actually have.
Yeah, 3,700. They're probably going to go, well, you already got a Galil on the board from Ocean. Galil on the board from Twist. They can buy a Galil or an AK on Els. He's not going to have any nades to work with. Scout in the hands of Invert and an AK for Ruru. So, it's a decent buy. They don't have a lot of smokes to work with, and it looks like they're opting for an A strategy, so they only have 3 smokes. And look at this push and underpass. They've already cleared this out, so they're already going to know. So they're going to have a really quick flank coming in towards the A bomb site. And you can already see Lucky's moving his way off of A, or off of B, pardon me. He's going to find his way over to A. Relics watching from connector. He's going to be primed and ready to go for this one as well. And the smokes come in. They've got one for CT, one for jungle, one for stairs. And now we see Relics. He's going to get aggressive behind this. So he's going to push on out. He's going to find first blood. Maybe. No, he actually goes down. So there's a good find early on.
Lucky, though, springs to the smoke, manages to grab Twist. Ruru responds to that, though, and takes down Lucky right after that. But now the flank is rolling in here. Mainline finding a kill into Els. It was a great peek from Invert to take down Mainline directly after that. But he got greedy, re-peeked it, and Uber punishes him for that. However, Ruru is still hanging on. He picks down Uber, and it's all on Nifty. But he finds one pickup, and now looking for that final one. He knows Ocean's behind there somewhere. Just spotted him. Jumps up on the box. It closes it out. That's 2 clutches in this half from Nifty, and he's going to find it to close out this match. 16 to 11 is going to be the final score, and the guys from Selfless